G'day guys, and welcome back to 72T. In today's video, we're going to be telling you what resolution a DVD is, a Blu-ray, and an Ultra Blu-ray disc is going to be. Now, this gives you a general idea if you have a few DVDs and you have no idea what resolution a DVD is and what resolution a Blu-ray is and basically what makes them different. We're going to talk all about that today and basically tell you if you don't have a DVD or you want to either collect Blu-rays or DVDs, which one is better to do for the resolution. Let's get into it, let's talk all about it, and let's start right now. So you're probably wondering, the first thing we're going to talk about, what does DVD stand for? Have you guys got any idea? It actually stands for Digital Versatile Disc. And basically what I thought, I always thought DVD stood for Digital Video Disc, but it absolutely does not stand for that. And you're probably wondering, what does Blu-ray stand for? So Blu-ray doesn't really stand for anything. The only thing that really comes out of the Blu-ray name is because it uses a blue laser to scan the disc. With a DVD, it uses a red laser to scan the disc. So that's why whenever you put a Blu-ray into a DVD player, it doesn't recognize the disc at all, or it won't allow it. Now, another reason it doesn't work as well is because the resolution is so much different. A Blu-ray disc is so much different to a DVD disc, and we'll talk about the resolutions very soon. So that's basically the difference between DVD and Blu-ray. One uses a red laser, so DVD uses red laser, and Blu-ray uses a blue laser. Let's get into it, and now let's talk about the resolution. Now, we're not just going to be talking about the resolution, we're also going to be talking about the audio. So if you want to have the best audio experience, we're going to be telling you which has the best audio. So let's start over at DVDs. So as you see, for DVDs, we're going to be looking at 720x480. So what does that mean? So the total resolution, depending on the DVD, the total max resolution that a DVD can support is 720p. But most DVDs support 480p, 480i. So most DVDs have 480i. However, a lot of DVD players have machine learning and it makes the actual DVD look like it's in 1080p, but it really isn't. So that's the resolution that you're looking at for a DVD. So again, that is 720x480, and it's normally 480i or it's 720p. But yeah, that's normally the resolution that you see on a DVD. Just to give you a bit of an idea, if you're wondering what resolution and why it's not so sharp, that's why it can't go, the resolution on a DVD max is 720p. It cannot go any higher at all. So keep that in mind. Now when we talk about a Blu-ray. So a Blu-ray has a lot more room. So we can go, the resolution is a little bit better. So we're looking at 1920x1080p. So that's a lot better in resolution, okay? You're getting a way better picture right here. And that is one of the great things. So you're getting crystal clear picture room. So that's one thing you need to keep in mind with the Blu-ray. That's why, that's the difference to Blu-ray and DVD. There's a big difference right there. And also then you've got your, now this is still a Blu-ray. Now, some people argue that it's not a Blu-ray. With 4K Ultra HD, people claim it is not associated with Blu-ray. And I can tell you right now, 4K Ultra HD is Blu-ray, okay? It is Blu-ray. It is a Blu-ray disc. If you put this in anything else, it won't work, okay? So remember that. 4K Ultra is not like a third generation disc reader. It is a Blu-ray player. It is Blu-ray. And the max resolution on Ultra 4K is going to be 3840x2160. But again, it is still Blu-ray. So keep that in mind. It is a Blu-ray. A lot of people argue it's not a Blu-ray, it's a third generation disc reading. The only thing that makes it third generation is the fact that you do need to have a 4K Blu-ray player. If you don't have 4K Blu-ray player, it will not work. Okay, so keep that in mind as well. So if you do buy a lot of the Ultra 4K Blu-ray discs, you will find they won't work on your Blu-ray player if it doesn't actually native have 4K. Again, you'll have to have a 4K TV as well. But keep in mind, when you buy a 4K disc, behind it, it always has the standard disc. So it gives you the standard Blu-ray. So if you don't have a 4K TV and you're thinking of getting one later in the track, you have the 4K disc, but also you have the standard Blu-ray, which allows you to watch 1920x1080p resolution, which actually comes in handy quite often. Now let's talk about the audio. So what sort of audio does a DVD player, a DVD film give you? What sort of audio? And what sort of audio does a Blu-ray give you? And also, there's one extra thing that I find that you get with the 4K Ultra HD Blu-rays. I've been mucking around with a few discs and having a look at all the audio settings, and there's a few other settings you do get when you buy an Ultra 4K DVD Blu-ray disc, and we'll talk about that right now. Okay, so we'll first start off with the DVD, because we'll get that started. So if you're wondering what audio is supported with DVD, now if you've got a pretty advanced DVD player, or you're using a Blu-ray player, but you've got a lot of DVDs, what resolution, what audio are you pretty much going to get? So the max audio with DVDs is normally the DTS 5:1 surround sound. Also, you've got the Adobe Audio built in as well. So if you've got an Adobe system, sound system, yeah, it'll be supported. The sound will be great. However, the audio is a lot more advanced on a Blu-ray disc, as it has more supported audios. So that will give you, you're gonna have Adobe Audio Plus. So you got that great audio right there. So keep in mind, the audio is gonna be good on the DVD, but still having a Blu-ray will give you that more crisp audio, and that's one of the great things with it. So let's tell you the audios that you get with a Blu-ray. So there's three main ones, and let's talk about them. So the three main audios that are included with most Blu-ray discs, pretty much all Blu-ray discs actually, and we'll talk about the first one. So the first one is DTS HD, which that allows 5:1 plus 7:1. So if you've got a 7:1 surround sound, that will work. Also, you got Adobe Digital Plus, so that will allow you to watch all your Adobe Digital stuff. 7:1, 5:1 will work great. Also, you got Adobe True HD, and that's more for AV set-top boxes. So if you, well, not set-top boxes, AV receivers. So from your Blu-ray player, you connect it to an AV receiver. Not the best audio, but it does support most of the Blu-rays will support it. The only extra thing that you do get if you have a Blu-ray and it's 4K. Now again, you can let us know if this works on the standard Blu-rays, but what I noticed is before you hit play, you're gonna see an audio icon. When you click on the audio icon, I found on the 4K disc, you have an option to turn Dolby Atmos on. So you can turn Dolby Atmos on if that is something you wanna do. And trust me, the sound on that is amazing. I could actually turn Dolby Atmos on, and I found that was pretty cool. I couldn't do that on the standard Blu-ray disc. I could only do that on the 4K disc. And it actually sounded absolutely amazing, that the fact that it supports Dolby Atmos. One thing I will note, especially when you're streaming 4K content and watching the hard copy of 4K content, one thing I noticed immediately, the audio, not so much the picture, like the picture is pretty much basically the same, maybe a couple of percent better resolution if you're watching the hard copy via disc, and the 4K does look a lot better. But I did find, because the audio, it's running 7:1, that's normally a 7 meg connection to get that sort of audio. Because it's a hard copy, the audio is just amazing. You don't have any interference. You can hear the quality of the audio. So that's something you can keep in mind if you did want to collect 4K copies of things. Definitely buy the disc version, because the audio does sound a lot more better than if you were going to stream it. So that's one thing I would definitely recommend. And you can check it out for yourself if you want to. So yeah, I just wanted to talk a little bit about what resolution a DVD is. So that's 480i to 720p. Or for Blu-rays, that's 1920 to 1080p, which is 1080p resolution. Or you can go your 4K Ultra HD Blu-ray, and that gives you a total aspect ratio of 3840 times 2160p. So yeah, if you found it helpful, or let us know down below. We'd love to hear your feedback. And yeah, let us know what you think about today's video, and we'll catch you guys in the next one.